if we play our cards right. But if I was a rider, I'd want to land here. I want to land about here, about 1.8 metres off the fence. Then what I'm going to do, one, two, three, four. That's about one stride for my horse. So I've taken one stride, two strides, three strides, four strides, and now five strides. So as I land over that first fence, I only have five strides in which to get myself set up to jump the second of these verticals, which is sitting here. If you look on this, in fact, I'll go down this way. If you look on this here, that rail sits on a plastic cup. There is only about 12 mil on that cup, and there's plastic on the end of that rail. The rails only weigh about 14 kilos. So if you look, very little effort is taken to knock that rail down. The object of the game of show jumping is to try and jump this course. I better rebuild it, I suppose. And I'm no strongman, and look how easily we put that back up. So the object of the game is to try and jump this course without fault. From fence number three, and remember, this has got 12 fences in this course. From fence number three, I come straight around the corner, and you can see this bread fence. And again, I walk my distance. So I land about two paces away. One stride, two strides, three strides, four non-jumping strides to fence number five. And again, that same concept, sitting there on a flat cup or a very, very light roll in the cup, gives us our fifth fence. From here, this would be a related line, and all the riders will have walked from fence five down to fence number six. Because I'm not riding in it, because I don't want to get it wrong, there are a couple of different lines you could take. You could ride in a very direct line down here to fence number six, or you could actually ride where I've walked in a nice arc and get out nice and straight. And now we're at a vertical that is just on 1.60 metres in height. Massive fence. Sitting here, you've jumped Oxa or a spread fence to a vertical, back to another vertical. Then you've got to land, re-engage your horse, get him cantering nice and strong, because you come around the corner. And let's just have a look at the width of this fence here. Here's the front rail of it. I cannot touch the back rail of it. So if you imagine, as you canter in here, you are looking at a really, really big and rampy jump. The front rail still counts, so you definitely don't want to knock that off. But wherever else we've been about 1.8 metres away from the fence, here we probably want to be only about a metre away, because we want the height of our jump, the ultimate height of our jump, to be peaking here. If we peak too early and we come down on this back rail, the cup will actually just simply fall out. It'll just drop away. In fact, we could show you exactly how this works. I'll just sit that down there for a minute. That cup can literally just drop straight out of there, just like that. If I can punch that down with my hand, imagine how little pressure our horses need to put on it to knock that cup out. And it doesn't get any easier from here, because we are on a related distance down to the treble, which is a really big, tough fence to jump. Yeah, really, really interesting. I didn't talk then because I really wanted to concentrate. Triple bar is getting your horse to jump out. You're coming down to a vertical here. It'll be interesting to see where the riders go in the six. There's a six, a five, or a seven there, just depending on the line you take. Direct five will be very forward. I think the six is what you're looking for. Then you've got to jump the A element of this combination. Again, we take our two strides. This is about where we'll land. One, two, three. There's one stride. There's our second stride. So two non-jumping strides in here. And you've got to back up, jump a big wide spread fence, and then to go again to the C element. Treat it as one fence. nice two strides in there, but having had the triple bar, a six stride line on the curve to the treble, this fence here I think could play a bit of a part, jumping the width of that oxer, then backing up and jumping out here. We then come around to our naming rights fence here to look at the rest of the course. Fence number 9. Big thank you to Winning Appliances and the winning group, to John and Kerry Winning for their support of our Grand Prix here this afternoon. They come around to fence number 9. Now, the interesting thing about this fence is look how much narrow it is. So on all the other fences, when I've stood in the middle of it, I've had quite a bit of room on either side of me. This fence here, the rails are actually only just over 2 metres, 2.2 metres in width. All our other rails are at 3.6 metres. That makes these rails extremely light and really easy to come down. The other part here is the spread on this oxer would have to be out at 1.60 metres, maybe even 1.65 metres. It is a really, really wide oxer. Coming off the back of the treble on a really hard right-hand turn, in my low opinion, I do believe this fence would be one that's going to come down quite a bit. We bring out our beautiful vehicle for the Winning Appliances. It sits out here. Gives our horses a bit of a reference point to come around, and we can see it sitting there. They're going to come around to the second of the combinations. And if there has ever been a tough fence on this course throughout the course of the week, this flower jump, and I can't really put a finger onto why, has caused more problems than any other jump. We get to our takeoff point again, about 1.8 metres or 6 foot in the old term. We jump over this fence, big, wide, scopy oxer coming into the A element. Land about 1.8 metres away. We take off one stride through. So only one non-jumping stride through this. And now the heat is really turned up on these horses and riders. Three fences left to go in this course. They have 13 fences. And there is no time to gather. You've got a head full of steam. You've made 1,000 decisions between the start and the finish of the course. You come around to this fence number 11. Furthest away from all your where your friends are. So they come in over there near the big screen, and they are right up this end of the arena. It's echoey, there's noise, there's people talking. The horse has done a lot of work between start and fence number 11. And to add to that, sitting down here on the ground is a little water tray. Just enough to maybe catch the horse's eye and take his job or her job off that top rail. And again, we can see how wide this fence is. And just because our course designer knows that we are playing for very good prize money here today, there are two fences, all related on this left-hand wheel, past the Sinclair and up to the Martin Angus stand. We'll have a little look at the distance here. Again, a nice six strides on the arc, but if you're too direct, you're going to end up too close. If you're too far to the right, you're going to end up too far away. Now, the interesting thing about this fence, we must jump through the flags. So the flags that we have here, red is always on the right, white is always on the left, but that block there, well, I think it would be lucky to weigh 5 kilos. Sits on there, and if you knock one block out of that wall, that is 4 jumping penalties. So the degree of difficulty for this fence here, a horse really cannot afford to make any mistake. He must jump it clean. And again, we've just come from the Liverpool with the water tray off the back of a very tough combination to this wall, which is at 1.60 metres. It's right up there on my shoulder. And we then got to come through to the final fence. The Lucky I'm not a Grand Prix rider because I'd be in all sorts of trouble with the distance I've just walked there. The riders are going to see there's either a 6 or a 7. I think at this point in the competition they'd go in the 6, but I think the 7 is going to have them too far away and they're really going to have to work to this final fence. So we can see the course. We've got fences 1 to 13. The first combination coming up there, it's the treble of 8A, 8B, 8C. We've got a triple bar at fence number 7, the really wide, rampy fence. And then we've got this last line, which I think is going to be where we really need to support our riders. This is where they're going to really having to be digging in deep and going back to years upon years of training. Because this is probably the toughest line on the course. Once you go from 10A, once you jump 9, you don't get a moment to catch your breath. You go 9, 10A, 10B, the flower combination, and then all the way around the outside curve of this arena for the first round. You cross the finish line, you stop the clock, and you need to be under the time allowed. It is a really interesting course. If we have a look at the field, there are 21 nominated horses in this competition, 8 of which have been in Europe in the last 12 to 18 months that are back here in Australia to compete at this level of competition. We are so fortunate that the RAS of New South Wales gives us an opportunity to showcase our sport of show jumping and allow them to really work and put together a great competition. We're also fortunate here today, if you're in the grandstand, you are going to witness some of the best show jumping that we have seen anywhere in the country to date. It is a real privilege to be presenting it, and our first horse is due on course in about 6 minutes' time at 2:15 this afternoon, and we really look forward to presenting the event. Out here in the arena at the moment, discussing with our course designer, we welcome board member of the RAS and councillor Michael Milner. Of course, we welcome our president of the Royal Agricultural Society of New South Wales, Mr. Robert Ryan, and also some associated guests who have had a chance to walk the course who won a lucky door prize here today at the Royal Agricultural Society of New South Wales last night at a show jumping of showcase event. Werner is our course designer. He's talking at the moment with our dignitaries. I'm just going to hang here for a moment and see whether we can just get a final word from him. No? You don't want to talk to me, Werner? You will. I feel terrible interrupting our president. Werner, firstly, welcome here to Sydney. Our fifth year, we'll just face this way if we can because we want to get your... No, face this way. There we go. I'm just looking to where I'm facing. Werner, welcome to Sydney. It's been wonderful to have you here again this year. We love having you here. Have you enjoyed your time?
For sure, I enjoy the people here. I love the country, and it's great to work again here in the Royal Easter. What is a fantastic, fantastic show for me.
Now, Werner, you were a top rider for many, many years. You then turned your hand to course designing. You travel all around the world. And in fact, you haven't been home for near 7.5 weeks. You've been all the way around. You've been to New Zealand, to America, back to Australia. Do you ever get tired of it?
No. Why? I'm young enough to do that.
The course we see here today, it is a tough course. I had a walk of it. Lucky, I wish I had a horse good enough, but I don't. So I'll talk about it instead. Have you been, what's your thoughts on the course?
Okay, first of all, it's very long. It's 580 meters long. And I'm a little bit focused today on verticals and on big verticals. So we end up at the end with 155 in the first round. And depends how many rounds we have. For sure, we have 2 160 in the second round.
That on an international level puts us right up there, doesn't it?
Yeah, it is, absolutely. It's European standard what I'm building. I cannot change my handwriting. I just had a conversation with the president of RAS before, and he said, do you change something? I said, no. Why? I'm here, and I show German European standard, and okay, and they have to jump it anyway.
You've had a look at the field. You've seen them jumping over the last couple of days. We've got a really strong field, I believe, we've put here. Do you think we've got horses good enough to jump clean around this course today?
For sure, and not only one. We have, I never say how many clear rounds I'm waiting for, but we have some clear rounds for sure.
Well, Werner, on behalf of show jumping enthusiasts like myself and all of the competitors, thank you so much for coming down here to the Southern Hemisphere, for building beautiful courses. Sport needs drama. You have created drama here this week. We have loved it. You've had us on the edge of our seat all week long, and it wouldn't happen without a great course designer like yourself.
Thank you, Tim. It's always a pleasure to be here, and I'm happy that the riders enjoy it or not. I don't ask them.
Ladies and gentlemen, could you please thank our course designer from Germany, international course designer, Mr. Werner Dieg. I'm going to make my way back up to the broadcast box. We are only minutes away from our first horse on course in the Sydney Royal Grand Prix show jumping event. We heard it straight from the horse's mouth. This is an international standard competition. Don't go anywhere. It's going to be amazing here this afternoon.
Well, we can announce the results of Class 666, the non-Hackney Stallion or Colt over 14 hands. And congratulations to catalogue number 1224, Christine Cantrell from Orange with Dreamer's Gold. And in second place, catalogue 2383, Rosalind Wagstaff and Australian Arabian Stud with Pavenzi, Don't You Know It's Magic.
Thank you, Kate. Well, our first horse is on course in the Sydney Royal Easter Show Grand Prix show jumping event. We welcome out James Arkins. James is riding Rothwaite Vigilante 2. 580 metres the length of the course. Time allowed, 100 seconds. 13 fences on the course as set by our course designer, Mr. Werner Dieg. Officiating in the Jim Barnes jury box, we have our head judge from Singapore, Mr. Ho Na Yu, being assisted today by Tim Danzy. So James Arkins carrying the 8 jumping penalties at this stage. 2 fences that have fallen to the ground at fence number 2 and also fence number 4. Here's where it is a long way to the finish line. So close, but lots of work to be done. Thank you. Well, safely over the last and through the finish line, stops the clock, 81.80. You can see the two fences that need rebuilding, so that is eight jumping penalties, no time penalties, a total of eight.
And then we have class 764, the lady driver class, for lady drivers 18 years and over.
And we are riding here today thanks to our naming rights sponsor of this class, Winning Appliances and Appliances Online. Big thank you to John and Kerry Winning and all of the sundry involved with Winning Appliances and Yandu Equestrian Services. The sport does not happen without sponsors, and we do thank them very much for their kind and generous support of the Sydney Royal Easter Show Grand Prix show jumping event. Well, next out into the arena, we welcome the second competitor in this competition. In fact, if you look at the Frank Thomas Memorial Perpetual Trophy and you look at 2016, it was won by Master James Hetherington, riding JB Carabas. Back to defend his title in 2017, we welcome a young man who's now based on in the Hunter Valley, born and bred at Tamworth in northern New South Wales. And he is the next rider to go. Time allowed is 88 seconds. That is a change from the course plan, so they are just making sure that James Hetherington is aware of the time allowed. Time allowed on this first round of competition is 88 seconds. So he will just be informed by our steward down there, Dave Chittick, who the length of the course, 580 metres, time allowed, 88 seconds. James Hetherington salutes to our judge, and he has 45 seconds in which to commence his round of show jumping. So if you've watched show jumping lots throughout the show or throughout your lifetime, you'll understand the rules. But there are plenty of us that are seeing show jumping for the first time. Firstly, welcome here to the Spotless Stadium. We hope you enjoy what is an international standard of show jumping here at the Sydney Royal Easter Show. This competition is run under international rules. We have an international course designer and an international judge. Although our judge is from Singapore, you could actually be the judge out in the grandstand. It is quite simple to follow. In that layman's terms, every rider starts on that score of zero. If they alter the height or width of any of our jumps, then they pick up four jumping penalties. In the sport of show jumping, the object of the game is to try and stay on that best possible score of zero. Penalties are also incurred for exceeding the time allowed. So if you went over the 88 seconds, you get one time penalty for every 4 seconds or part thereof that you are over the time allowed. James Hetherington is the rider on course, riding JB Carabas. And no jumps have had their top rail knocked off. They haven't altered the height or width. As he comes around to fence number 10, he is all clear at this stage. Just carrying the four jumping penalties as he comes down to the final fence. Further four at the last. Give him a round of applause. That's a great ride. We said it was very tough when we walked the course. Those last three fences, they come quick. They come into your face very, very quickly, and the rider can't afford to make a single mistake. Eight jumping penalties. Time taken, 84.79. So under the time allowed, 84.79. Eight jumping penalties, no time penalties, a total of eight. Now we're running this course class under Article 273, 3.3 and 4.3. That is the international rules that we're running under. What it means, we'll run this competition over two rounds of jumping, and the winner of the class will be the horse-rider combination with the least number of penalties over the two rounds. And if we are still on an equality of faults, with the quickest time in the second round of competition. James Hetherington completed his round on a total of eight. We will take a minimum of 25% of the field into the second round of proceedings. and we will actually have a new course walk, and the riders who qualify for the second round will come back out and commence the second round. Next into the arena, we welcome Billy Raymond, and Billy is riding Anton. Anton, nominated by Michelle and Tim Clark and Mrs. Bryce from Malala in South Australia. Billy is a top show jumper and has been here for many, many years. He has knocked on the door of this Grand Prix on many occasions, but has never actually been able to win it. So he's four jumping penalties at the third fence on the course. So you can see how we can actually judge it ourselves on the outside. Of course, we keep official scores, but you can keep up with what is going. This is where they test the power and the scope of the horse, how big it can jump consistently over jumps. Just the four at this stage. Earlier today, we saw four jumping penalties qualify for the final. So if he can stay on that penalties, he potentially could be in the competition for the second round. Billy Raymond, he's up, he's over through the finish line. What a ride. 81-2-0, just the one rail down. Four jumping penalties, no time penalties. A total of four for Billy Raymond and Anton. And that is a great way to start. Three horses, 2 8 jumping penalties and a 4 jumping penalties. And interestingly enough, not the same fence has fallen at any place. And that is what we want to see, because what that means, there isn't one point out here that is really tricky to jump. In fact, they're all jumpable. Can they all be jumped clean, however? Well, one of the horses that has been based in Europe, making its way back here to Australia for the 2017 series, bred in Australia by Rod and Kathy Brown and the team at Equus Australia. It is Equus Echo and Jessica Brown. And Jess was based in Europe for a little over 18 months. And she has decided to bring her team of horses back here to Australia. And she won her big competition up at Tamworth just 2 weeks ago. It looked superb here this weekend. And knowing Jess and Rod, they will have been prepping this horse for today. This is the one that we all want to win. The Frank Thomas Memorial Perpetual Trophy for the Grand Prix at Sydney Royal is a horse, a combination that is remembered in history. $1.55 this course. Over the winning appliances fence. That's the narrow one with the really, really light rails. Rattles the B element. Now, it doesn't matter about form, how neatly you jump the jump, just whether you jump it cleanly or not. Over 11. One fence left to go. Time looks all right. She comes down to the final fence. Hey, ladies and gentlemen of Sydney, put your hands together. 82.29. No jumping penalties, no time penalties. That is our first clear round here this afternoon. Well done to the team at Equus Australia. Equus Echo, Jessica Brown, no jumping penalties, no time penalties, and all clear. She is a lovely rider. She made it look very effortless, a lot easier than what it worked. A big crap pat to the horse, a big smile to the crowd for Jessica Brown and Equus Echo. As we now move down the board, we welcome out number 6 in the draw, and this is Andrew Lamb, and Andrew riding CP Argento. The runner-up, 2016 Australian Show Jumping Champion. This horse bred at Chatham Park by George Sanna and the team. Purchased as a young horse by Andrew Lamb. And it has come up through the grades with Andrew at the helm. Andrew, one of our few riders who is not a full-time show jumper. His wife spends a majority of her time keeping the horses in work, but Andrew, when he's not riding show jumpers, his weekday job is a dairy farmer down there in the East Gippsland of Victoria. And to be able to work full-time and still ride at Grand Prix level is no mean feat. And a credit and true testament to the partnership that he and his wife, Ali, run. See how they have to move up to that triple bar. And they've got to come back and hold themselves through the combination. Comes up to the wall, one fence left to go. He's safely over the last. Hey, Sydney, put your hands together. What a ride. Two in a row. That is a treat in show jumping. Andrew Inglis, CP Argento. No jumping penalties, no time penalties, and all clear. And that is our second clear round. So we will take a minimum of 25% of the field back or all clears. So we will guarantee a spot in the second round if you jump clear. And I would think that there will be some horses with faults as well, but really we'll just see what happens here in this first round. Well, we now welcome out into the arena Clem Smith. Now, Clem, he was the leading Group A Section 1 horse here at the Sydney Royal Easter Show this year, judged over the first 5 days. He is riding Leanne Brueggemann and Clem Smith's nomination of Guru. And Guru, he has been a top show jumper. He does carry his little quirks and perks that many people don't realise. And Clem and Charlene and the team do an amazing job to manage this horse to keep him through to Grand Prix level. In 2012, they ran the Australian runner-up show jumping champion. And they have won Grand Prix in Queensland, New South Wales, Victoria and South Australia as a combination. And Clem, a professional show jumping rider, horse breaker and trainer. And he is one of the gentlemen of the sport. Always understated, the quiet achiever in show jumping. And it's great to welcome him here to the Sydney Royal Easter Show. Clem Smith and Guru, the combination, now on course. Two fences left to go. Nicely over the appliances on line wall. He looks for the open stride. He gets in close to the last. He's up. He's over through the finish line. Stops the clock. 81.77. That's the hat trick. Three clear rounds in a row. Clem Smith and Guru guarantee themselves a spot in the second round. No jumping penalties, no time penalties, and all clear. Give us our third clear round in the competition. Clem Smith joins the list with Jess Brown and Andrew Lamb. Well, as Clem leaves the arena, we welcome out the other half of the Lamb partnership. This is Ali Lamb riding Diamond B Corsica. Diamond B Corsica, nominated and ridden by Ali Lamb. Bred by Diamond B Stud, actually another stud here in New South Wales. In fact, at Wilberforce in Western Sydney, Helen Chug and Diamond B Stud bred this horse. It's by ASB Conquistador, who is now based in America. Born here in Australia from imported bloodlines. And ASB Conquistador aside, many, many champions. Diamond B Corsica is stepping up from the Group A Section 2 part into the Group A Section 1. And this is a big step up for a young horse. But Ali Lamb, a very skilled and talented show jumper. It's interesting, in equestrian at Olympic level, firstly, we have Two Hearts, and that has been the FEI's promotional program. Two Hearts competing for the one goal, and then also at equestrian at an international level and right through in our show jumping, men and women compete on an equal playing field. We don't have competitions for men or for women. And a lot of the time, it's not about being the strongest or the toughest rider. It's about being the best partner to your horse. It really is a partnership. Now, Ali's husband, Andrew, jumped clean. Can the Lambs get two clear rounds? Tough too, because they were very close together. And in a family unit, you really want to watch your partner go. So a rail down at 10A, carrying four jumping penalties at this stage. Two fences left to go. The wall stays there. Does she go on the rolling stride? She just waits to the base. Unfortunately, it doesn't pay dividend. Eight jumping penalties. Time taken, 88.45. Now, time allowed is 88 seconds. So just over the time allowed. Eight jumping penalties, one time penalty, a total of nine for Ali Lamb and Diamond B Corsica. So three clear rounds, one rider on four jumping penalties, two riders on eight jumping penalties, as we now welcome out from Bega on the south coast of New South Wales, Clint Beresford. He rides a horse bred by Grant and Heather Hughes out of Dina, who was a Daily K mare, by Junebug, who was Jeremy Inglis's top Grand Prix horse for many, many years, and is unfortunately now deceased. Emmerville Jitterbug, or Jason, he's known around the stables, was purchased by Warren and Jenny Beresford for their son Clinton as a young horse, and Clint has brought him up through the grades. And in 2016, he won the World Cup Series here in Australia and has been voted the Domestic Rider of the Year across all disciplines by Equestrian Australia, and a great accolade to a young man. Very much a family unit. It's great to welcome the Beresfords here to Sydney Royal Easter Show. And on course now, we welcome Clint Beresford, and he is riding Emmerville Jitterbug. Just carrying the final fence, carrying the four jumping penalties, safely over the last, stops the clock, 81.38, a rail down at 10B, four jumping penalties, no time penalties, a total of four for Clint Beresford and Emmerville Jitterbug. As we now welcome out into the arena, Nicole Brueggemann, and Nicole is riding number 10 in the draw, Lux Like Cavalier. Nicole comes to us from South Australia, and she has made the trip up from Gawler. And this year at the Royal, we are lucky to have competitors from New Zealand, Western Australia, South Australia, Victoria, New South Wales and Queensland. We have got competitors from all around coming here to compete at the Sydney Royal Easter Show. From South Australia, we welcome out Leanne Brueggemann and Nicole Brueggemann, nomination of Lux Like Cavalier.
And in the saddle, we welcome Nicole Brueggemann. Nicole won the Australian Young Rider Championship in her final year in 2016. And looking to post our fourth clear round. Nicole Brueggemann, Lux Like Cavalier, the combination on course. And in fact, Nicole, even though from South Australia, is the current New South Wales country show jumping champion that she won in October of 2016 down in the Riverina at Wagga Wagga. Oh, clever pony. Clever ride. Didn't quite get to where she wanted at the start of the treble. So she was clear through there. Unfortunately, the back rail falls to the ground on fence number 9, the Winning Appliances fence. Once again, a big thank you to Winning Appliances and the winning group for Appliances Online. Winning Appliances, we do thank them for their support at the Sydney Royal Easter Show. One fence left to go, just carrying the four jumping penalties. Safely over the last, stops the clock. Oh, just over the time allowed. 88.27, four jumping penalties, one time penalty. A total of 5 for Nicole Brueggemann and Lux Like Cavalier. So give her a total of 5 at this stage. Two riders on 4 jumping penalties, Clint Beresford and Emmaville Jitterbug. And Billy Raymond and Anton. And then we have 3 clear rounds. Equus Echo, Jessica Brown, CPR Gento, Andrew Lamb, and Guru, and Clem Smith. We are going to now allow our ring crew to come out and roll the going. The reason we are doing that is we're trying to keep the surface as consistent for all of our horses. And so we are going to run the roller around this course and give our horses and riders that are still to come a fair go on the ground. When you're jumping this big, you want to try and have the ground as good as possible. And the RAS has worked tirelessly here this year to keep the footing, that first-class footing that we always get. Of course, at all of our major shows around the world, this happens all the time. So this is quite common practice. And as we roll the arena, Kate, we turn our attention to our two other classes because we have two other classes taking place here in our main arena.
Thank you very much. Yes, a challenging class here for our judge, Ms. Lynette Fritsch, to judge because this class 764 is very large and it's the lady driver class. So it's for lady drivers 18 years and over. No jokes, please, Tim. We've already discussed this over the past days. We have some excellent lady drivers and their skills are currently on display now in the main arena. And then we have class 672, and that is on the far side underneath the Cumberland stand, and that's the Hackney Harness Horse, over 14 hands and driven in a gig. No stallions in this particular class. So that's our class 672 with our judge, Mr. Andy Cusack. So the lady drivers look fabulous out there. We were treated last night with the harness parade, and many of our exhibitors were actually taking part in that, and lovely to see them out in the sunshine. The decision will not be far away, I'm guessing. Of course, these days we have cars that can park themselves, but 100 years ago, this was our main way of getting around, and wonderful that the tradition is maintained and all of the history is preserved, and many of these vehicles are original or exact replicas, with many components being original. And we've seen wonderful turnout classes, and the amount of work and labour and dedication that goes to maintaining and restoring these wonderful vehicles is really quite amazing. And, of course, Sydney Royal Show attracts the best exhibitors. It's a wonderful class of competition for them, and to have so many in a competition is fantastic. Meanwhile, with our Hackney harness horses on the other side, the Hackney breed is, of course, from England, and you might have seen it on many an episode of Downton Abbey, but the Hackney horses are known for their distinctive high-stepping action. They were flashy. They were the equivalent of the modern-day European car that, as a sign of some sort of kudos and wealth. But they also, the breed developed because they had fabulous stamina and could trot very quickly over long distances. So if you needed to get anywhere quickly, you would go in a Hackney vehicle. And they really took off in the 19th century when the road surfaces started to improve. And I suppose a bit more attention was taken to how one looked, so the appearance of the that look at me, that striking kind of action. They always have that lovely high headset and a high tail set as well, and that distinctive high leg action, and very practical, very fast, but also quite flamboyant and extravagant. So the vision on the big screen working its way down are a lineup of lady drivers waiting patiently for the decision.
Well, the next horse makes their way back into the arena for the continuation of the first round. Just one clarification. Clint Beresford and Emmaville Jitterbug had 8 jumping penalties, a rail down at 10B, and also a brick out of the wall at fence number 12, giving him a total of 8. That gives us 3 clear rounds, 1 4-fault round and 3 8-fault rounds, with Nicole Brueggemann on a total of 5. With 1-4 jumping one time. Next out into the arena, he's already completed the course once. This time he rides the winner of the Sydney Open Grand Prix Sunday a week ago, where he and Da Vinci's Pride took home $10,000 in prize money. Now riding here at the Sydney Royal Easter Show Grand Prix, it is James Arkins from Mossvale, and he is riding Da Vinci's Pride. Cheap as he's known around the stables, a well-performed Grand Prix horse. Not the most orthodox going horse. He certainly has developed a great relationship with James. And they are on course now. If you've just joined us here in the Spotless Stadium, perfect timing. We're in halfway through the first round of going. So we will take the top 10 through, or 25% of the class, or nearly 50% actually, to the second round of competition, which is due to start just after 4 o'clock. We will rebuild and rewalk the course. And it's interesting, today obviously not the day for James Arkins. He's carrying 16 jumping penalties. Safely over 12, comes down to the final fence, safely over the last, stops the clock, 77-4-8. Four fences that need rebuilding, 16 jumping penalties, no time penalties, a total of 16 for Da Vinci's Pride and James Arkins. Well, next out into the arena, they welcome Stephen Hill, and Stephen riding Yolambi's Bellini Star. This combination, they have won the Kevin Burke Memorial Perpetual Trophy for winner of the Mini Prix. They have never won the Frank Thomas Memorial Perpetual Trophy, another horse that has been based in Europe. In fact, these last two horses have both been in Europe and now come back to Australia. And this is bred by Rory Hovell. And Rory Hovell's horse, Yolambi's Capino Z, won this class in 2015. Yolambi Bellini Star is a warm blood mare, and she is one of our best horses in the country. And Stephen Hill, a bricklayer by trade. He now is a show jumper, as well as working in the family business down there at Clunes. Stephen represented Australia in Nations Cup events right through Europe and had a great time competing over there. He deciding, though, that the homesickness was getting too much. He really wanted to come back and be part of the Australian show jumping scene. So he put his horse on a plane and flew her back here to Australia. Takes a lot of skill for a horse to jump a big wide oxer like that, back up one stride to jump a vertical out. Two fences left to go. Oh, Brick out of the wall, picks up four jumping penalties, comes down to the final fence, he drops to the ground as well. Eight jumping penalties, 81-5-7, 81-5-7, eight jumping penalties, no time penalties, a total of eight. When we walked the course, I did really think that that would catch more riders out than it has. Three fences on a continual left-hand arc is really asking a lot of both horse and rider to finish off a very long course, 580 metres in length. They must jump at it under 88 seconds. As we welcome out our New Zealand rider, or representing Team New Zealand, Bridget Hansen, and she is riding Toulon NZPH. Toulon NZPH was bred at Hawke's Bay in New Zealand, which is located on the east coast of the North Island, a very picturesque part of the world. And her mum and dad, Bridget and Walker Hansen from New Zealand Performance Horses, have bred some of the best horses in the country with international breeding. And in fact, their pedigrees are so well sought after these days that they actually export horses, not only to Australia, but right around the world. So Toulon NZPH through the first six fences, all clear at this stage. Oh, drops a rail at the triple bar. Well, stops the clock, 85-5, just under the time allowed of 88 seconds. Four fences need rebuilding, 16 jumping penalties, no time penalties, a total of 16 for Toulon NZPH and Bridget Hansen.
And we have the results of Class 672, the Hackney Harness Horse over 14 hands driven in a gig. And our winner was Mrs. Elsa Avery with nomination 1077 in your catalogue, Macquarie Blue Danube. And in second place, Ashwood's Tantalus, Ashley Allison Woods and Ashwood Hackney Stud and Family and Mrs. Robinson Alison Woods from Murrurundi and Ashwood's Tantalus. In third place, it was catalogue number 1405, Joanne Dorman and Mr. Darren Dorman and Mr. Jesse Dorman with Ashwood's Captivation. Congratulations to our winner in the Hackney Harness Horse, Ashwood's Tantalus.
Well, the bell sounds for the next of our show jumping riders. Thank you to Kate Day for that result. As we now welcome out into the arena, Gabrielle Cooner and Gabrielle riding Sierra Casiago. Sierra Casiago, bred by Kerry Parker, an imported horse. This horse was based in Europe with Chris Chugg and Gabby Cooner, and they decided to bring this horse home to continue its career. Started show jumping here in Australia, went to Europe while Chuggy was competing in the World Cup Series, and this horse was a big part to Chris Chugg winning the World Cup League in 2016-15 season. And he was in Gothenburg in this time last year, competing at the World Cup final. So, Gabby, clear over the first part of the course. She had a great day here the other day. This combination really have stepped up to Grand Prix level. They won the World Cup qualifier down at Borneo Park in January on the Mornington Peninsula. Nicely through the first part of the course. The combination and the three on the left-hand arc around the outside of the arena left to go. Time allowed 88 seconds. Should about 20 seconds on the clock. Shouldn't be a problem. Two fences now. Comes up to the wall. It looks clear. Gabby Cooner comes up to the final fence. She gets in close. Oh, unfortunately, draws a rail at the last. 82.71. 82.71. Four jumping penalties. No time penalties. A total of four.
And we have the results of our lady driver class, class 764. Congratulations to catalogue number 2071, Perfection Holdings and P&D Ward and Sons from Gresford with their horse Dancer. In second place, catalogue number 2076, Michelle Perry with Cheval Dreamcatcher. In third place, catalogue number 1646, John and Sandy Hunter with Arunga Buddy. In fourth place, catalogue 2003, Heather Oxenham from Frogmore with Ben Warren Park Prestige. In fifth place, catalogue number 2152, Demore Park Harness Horse Reinberger from Mudgee with Demore Park Pride. So congratulations there. That's the winner of our lady driver class and our place getters. And congratulations, Perfection Holdings and P&D Ward and Sons taking out class 764.
Thank you, Kate. Well, the next horse is on course in the show jumping arena. She's already got one clear round. Another horse that has been based in Europe and now back here in Australia. It is Jess Brown, and she is riding Casco. Casco, a warm blood gelding imported to Australia by Equus Australia. And that has been a wonderful horse for Jess. She rode for Australia at the Nations Cup final in Barcelona at the end of 2015, and jumped a superb round to put Australia into the top 15 in the world. But Casco today has had three rails down, carrying the 12 at this stage. And with that score on the board, Jess thinking today's not the day, and he who fights and runs away does live to fight another day, and she will retire from the competition. So that will be a retirement, and retired or eliminated combinations can't come back for the second round. As we now move on to the next of our competitors, number 17 in the draw, it is the current Australian show jumping champion, 2016 winner. Of the 2016 Australian show jumping champion and team member, the non-travelling reserve of the 2016 Rio Olympic Games, another horse that has been based in Europe but back here in Australia. It was bred by Alice Cameron, by Oaks Sport Horses, by Conquistador out of an Oaks, and Yandu Oaks Constellation is now owned by the winning family, Yandu Equestrian Services, and a great combination to be setting out onto the world stage. Jamie Kermond is the rider, and he is riding Napa, as he's known around the stables. A big, tall, rangy, warm blood gelding, and our next combination to go. All clear through the first part of the course. Two-time Australian show jumping champion, won it for the first time in 2012, again in 2016. Carrying four jumping penalties as he comes down to the final fence. Jamie Kermond, Yandu Oaks Constellation, safely over the last. Stops the clock, 84.88. Four jumping penalties, no time penalties, a total of four for Jamie Kermond and Yandu Oaks Constellation. As we now welcome out Brooke Dobbin, number 18 in the draw. And Brooke is riding Silvo. Silvo, imported from Canada, and has been a top horse with Brooke Dobbin at the helm. Had a win here the other day and looked on form. Can he back it up with a clear round today? So far, just the three clear rounds. They came in quick succession, three in a row. Jess Brown, Andrew Lamb and Clem Smith have all jumped clear. From Yarra Glen in Victoria, we welcome out Brooke Dobbin, and Brooke is riding Silvo. So eight jumping penalties so far, part of to both parts of the second combination come to the ground, so carrying 16 jumping penalties, and Brooke Dobbin also deciding his day's not today, and he bows out of the competition and retires after fence number 10. Well, there are just three horses, three riders left to go. And our next rider out will be number 19 in the draw. He had a win here in the Group A Section 1 competition yesterday. Won the EFA Perpetual Cup and joined a long list of top horses. If we look back down through the Frank Thomas Memorial Perpetual Trophy, as we said, in 2016 was won by James Hetherington, Alison Rowland, and Yolambi's Capino Z won it in 2015. Russell Johnson in 2014, Sharon Slater in 2013, and Tom McDermott in 2012 with CP Romantic Dream, and Julia Hargraves won it in 2011. Never been won by Stuart Jenkins. Stuart is our next rider out from Marlberg in southeast Queensland, and he rides Fairview Aliquidam. Jaunty, as he's known around the stables. He's a little pocket rocket. He is not a huge horse in stature, but he is a huge horse in personality and in heart. And Stuart Jenkins has been very strong in producing this horse. He's not been the easiest, but boy, when he is on, he is on. Stuart Jenkins, Fairview Aliquidam, the next of our combinations to go.
And coming into the main arena are Buggy Horse Over 14 Hands to be driven in a buggy, and that is our class 675. And we have a youth driver class 763 in ring 3 underneath the big screen, and that's our youth driver class for drivers between 12 and 18 years of age.
Well, Fairview Aliquidam picks up four jumping penalties at 7A, or 8A if I could actually count correctly. Draws a further four at the last, so eight jumping penalties, 81.07, eight jumping penalties, no time penalties, a total of eight for Stuart Jenkins and Fairview Aliquidam. That still means just the three clear rounds, three four-fault rounds and a five-fault round. As we now welcome out into the arena, number 20 in the draw. Second last competitor to go. And this is C.D. Visage and Kate Hinchin. Kate grew up at Mackay in far north Queensland. And her dad, Barry, is still based up there. Kate these days is based here in New South Wales at Chatham Park with George Sanna, is where she works as a groom and also rider. And she rides Dommy, as he's known around the stables. C.D. Visage was bred by Tom Doyle and commenced his career with Tom Doyle and Billy Raymond. And in fact, there was a memory shared on Facebook of this horse jumping here at a few years ago now with Billy Raymond, where he had great success. He is now ridden and owned by Kate. And Kate has certainly come up through the junior and young rider ranks, stepping out to World Cup level last year and has been at Grand Prix level with C.D. Visage for the last 6 months. But a big open track here today for this young lady. Big time player, certainly going to step up and keep up with all the open riders. Oh, railed down at 10A, so carrying four jumping penalties. Three fences left to go. Three jumping efforts. 11's right. Come on, Kate. 12's there. One fence left to go. One of our younger riders in this competition. Hey, Sydney, give her a round of applause. That's a great ride for the young gun, Kate Hinchin. 84.22. Just the one fence down, fence number 10A. Four jumping penalties, no time penalties, a total of four. And C.D. Visage leaves the arena. Kate Hinchin will be pretty proud of that. Great effort by horse and rider. Well, one combination left to go in this first round of competition. We welcome out Rebecca Jenkins, and Becky is riding RSB Jacana. What I loved about this is just before she went in, Lacey Jenkins, her daughter, ran down to the fence just to give Becky a last few pointers before she commenced her round. RSB Jacana, or Mia, as she's known around the stables, is a warm blood mare. And Becky has had this mare for many, many years now. They won a big Grand Prix, big World Cup qualifier, in fact, at Brisbane Ecker over a similar track. And this horse is a really good horse when she is on, and hoping to make today her day. From Marlberg in southeast Queensland, former Victorian, it is Becky Jenkins riding RSB Chicana. Unfortunately, a rail down at the first of the combination. So she's carrying four. I don't want to see any more rails fall to the ground. Nothing like a pressure ride for Becky Jenkins. Carrying eight jumping penalties. Three fences left to go, three jumping efforts. Comes up to 11's right. 12's there. Comes down to the final fence. Fence number 13. Safely over the last. Stops the clock. 84.47. Eight jumping penalties. No time penalties. A total of eight. Well, three clear rounds. They came in quick succession. Jessica Brown, Andrew Lamb and Clem Smith are all clear. We have a result still to come, and then we'll tell you how the second round of competition is going to take place.
And we have the winner of our Class 763, the Youth Driver Class, and that was judged on the ability of the driver only, and that class has actually left the arena, but we did see our young driver there, and congratulations to Catalog 2151, Damore Park Harness Horses Rheinberger from Mudgee with Damore Park Mason, winning the Youth Driver Class.
Can you print it?
And on the other side of the ring, we have 675 in action, and that was with our judge, Mr. Rodney Lane. It's the buggy horse over 14 hands, so obviously to be driven in a buggy. We do have stallions able to compete in this class, Class 675, as they begin their workouts.
Well, our judge has just informed us that eight faults and less is going to come back to the second round, and we'll see the order of going on time in the first round, plus penalties. So 14 competitors will be back. And this will be the second round of going over a whole new course with a start time in just under an hour's time from now. And the order will be James Hetherington, JB Carabas, Becky Jenkins, RSB Jacana, James Arkins and Rothwaite Vigilante 2, Stephen Hill and Yolambi's Bellini Star, Clint Beresford, Emmerville Jitterbug, so that is our eight falters. Oh, sorry, and Stuart Jenkins and Fairview Alequadam, that is all our eight falters. We then have one rider on five jumping penalties, Nicole Brueggemann, Lux Like Cavalier, Jamie Kermond, Yandu Oaks Constellation, Kate Hinchin, CD Visage, Gabby Cooner and Sarah Casiago, and Billy Raymond on Anton, they're our four fault riders. And then we go with our three clear rounds. Andrew Lamb, CP Argento, Jess Brown and Equus Echo, and Clem Smith and Guru. So our ring crew, they are going to build a whole new course out here. And we will bring the riders back out to walk that second round of going. And the first horse will be on course in exactly 1 hour's time at 4:15 this afternoon. And in the meantime, Kate, we have plenty of other action still to come here today in the Spotless Stadium.